My name is Liz Mané. I'm assistant professor of consumer research in this faculty of industrial design engineering here in Delft. My research focuses on consumers' acceptance and adoption of circular and sustainable alternatives, with a specific focus on packaging design. In terms of packaging, my feeling is that what's really important when there is an innovation is whether or not the physical appearance of the package changes. And if it doesn't change, yeah, basically for brands to get the innovation accepted, that's much easier. The challenge is maybe in communicating their innovations and how they did it and why they did it. When the visual appearance of the package does change, it creates much more challenges for brands. Because what we know about packaging appearance is that it helps consumers to categorize products. So what we also know from research is that if the visual appearance of the package becomes too atypical, then people tend to have more negative evaluations about the package. And the reason why, it is just that people can't just categorize it correctly. So make sure that the product is still perceived as being part of the same category as it was before, and also remain in the same field as the competitors, let's say. For example, there was this brand in the US called Seventh Generation, and they are selling laundry detergents. And some time ago, they really released this nice bottle, which was a shell made of recycled paper with a plastic liner inside. And the appearance really changed, and yeah, for some reasons, it started to sell a bit less. So then they went back to their plastic bottle, for example. Next to the visual appearance, I think it's very important for brands to keep in mind that they have to still keep the usual functions of the packaging, yeah, either constant or even improved. When I'm talking about usual functions, I'm talking about ease of use or convenience, for example. Also important when you change the appearance of a package to really monitor what are the inferences that consumer make based on the package design. And I wanted to talk maybe about this bottle introduced by Heineken in France in the cafes and restaurants. It's called the FOBO bottle, and it stands for forwardable bottle. And it's part of their efforts to make their packages more circular. So the bottles in a cafe and restaurant, the Horeca, they are returnable most of the time, which, yeah, is a nice thing, but there is also an inconvenience to that, is that the bottles, they get damaged, they get scratched, they get less shiny, and we know that consumers find these signs of wear and tear okay, but they also use these signs to create inference about the product itself, so the quality of the product. So they wanted to counteract this using design and by creating a bottle that would just age beautifully. So the more you use it, the more the star that's on the package becomes beautiful. They also have a unique code and a date on the package, and with this code, users or consumers are able to leave their story online, and the next consumers are able to just retrieve these stories and listen to it, and it just creates a nice story about the bottle and makes the returning system more attractive for consumers.